So Honor's come out with another smartphone, which is called the Honor 9i. We really don't know why it's called the 9i, but Nikhil and me are here again to give you a double whammy review of the all new Honor smartphone. So, what's so cool about the Honor 9i?
What I believe the I is for the two eyes it has on the front and the back. I don't know if that's what they wanted to name it like. And the coolest thing that you talked about is like, the coolest thing about this smartphone is the four camera. It's called the quad camera setup. And it's not the first phone with a quad camera setup, but
it is the first phone with a quad camera setup and a full vision display.
Correct.
So that is a combination that you really don't get. And
absolutely,
at a price point of ₹17,999,
absolutely,
it's a steal of a deal. The other thing that this smartphone has is that Huawei uses its own Kirin processor on it, and the seamless integration of hardware and software with that EMUI 5.1 is just brilliant. The apps run really smooth. The multitasking is pretty awesome on this smartphone. What's another thing that you found so cool on the Honor 9i?
See, what we've seen in past that they are the leaders of dual camera smartphones. We've already discussed this in the past. And bringing that dual camera setup in the front, I think they have always had the prowess of providing the best dual camera setups. So once you get it in the front also, you can do a lot of, you know, people like you and me who are creators, Facebook Live guys, we have a bokeh effect which can, you know, blur the background in the selfie mode also. So the background also has dual setup which gives like 16 plus 2 megapixel and gives you that great bokeh effect. On the front you get a 13 plus 2 megapixel setup, again bokeh effect and great cameras, great selfies. So I think this device is really, really thin, and the bezels are really thin. Again, having so many components in it and being so thin, and a 3300 plus mAh battery, I think it's a great deal, and the price is again unbeatable at that price.
And I would like to point out over here that on the rear camera, you have a pro video mode as well, where you can actually have a bokeh video effect as well. Obviously on a still frame, but if you move your phone around, you know, you might not get an accurate bokeh effect.
Correct.
Over there, which I think is really good, very innovative, and something that other companies should also try to implement on their dual camera smartphones. Another thing that we really liked on the new Honor 9i is the display. Now this is an 18:9 aspect ratio display, something which was started in a way by Samsung, and now you getting the similar kind of aspect ratio display on plenty of phones under 20,000 rupees smartphones. So we saw LG do this with their Q6. We saw Vivo recently came out with a 18:9 display. I mean, this is the new benchmark or standard for displays on smartphones, and I think Honor's keeping it up to date with the Honor 9i. Now it's time to tell you what's not so cool on the Honor 9i, and Nikhil and me both have had some issues with the phone.
I think the display is great, but you know, the sunlight legibility is not that great. I mean, we've been using it in the sun, and I think it could have been more brighter, more richer in colors, which is usually not the case with Honor smartphones. So maybe there's a software update they can bump it up with, maybe, I don't know, because I would like it a little more brighter.
And I personally think that maybe they've done, they've kept the brightness of the display at a lower ratio, because the display actually juices out a lot of battery, and it's just about a 3300 milliampere kind of a battery.
Correct.
So they don't want you to drain your battery really quickly, and that's why, you know, you lose out on visibility on the display, especially if you're walking outside and trying to use this smartphone. Now the other thing that we really didn't like on this smartphone is that though it's priced at about 18,000 rupees, they still don't give you a USB Type-C connector on the Honor 9i, which I think is something that all the companies should sit together once and say that, boss, all the phones coming out from our factory from now on are just going to have one USB Type-C. Because
correct,
it's really a big hassle. You know, the beauty of Android phones is that you can use a similar port for your data transfer, even for emergency charging. And this is something that you keep on shuffling between,
absolutely,
you know, USB Type-C and micro USB. So that is something I think that they really missed out
and
on.
For that matter, I think even Tim Cook should take a note on that, because they have their laptops with Type-C, but you cannot connect them with your phone. So that's something that I would like not only Android manufacturers, but Apple also to think about in the future.
That's a different debate and a video altogether. So those are the two things that we didn't like on the Honor 9i. And final words, final verdict, Nikhil, do you like the phone, do you don't like the phone?
I think I've always liked the way they build the devices and the camera capabilities of the Honor devices, and the pricing is also very good. So if you have like around 15 to 20,000 rupees, this is a device that you should consider.
And I think that if you are someone that wants the latest tech out there and you change your phones really often and have a budget right now between 15 to 20,000 rupees, this is probably the only phone that gives you a 4 camera setup and a full vision display, and it's cheaper than that Vivo phone as well.
Yeah.